Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to burn images and text onto toast and how to replace them without having to redo the effects. I provided this image that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. We'll create a displacement map which will wrap our text or image over the contours of the toast. To do this, the first step is to desaturate the toast by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. Since displacement maps look best when they're slightly blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Duplicate Layer. Click New and name it Displacement. Then click OK. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop so you can easily find it. Save it as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. Close the displacement map and go to your History panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and History. Click Open. This reverts our toast image back to its original state before we removed its color and blurred it. The next step will be to make a selection of the nooks and crannies of the toast, which we'll use later to add their textures to our burnt image and text. Go to Select and Color Range. Make sure Localized Color Clusters is checked. Make the fuzziness 31 and the range 21%. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Select and Save Selection. When you see this window, just click OK. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. I provided this image as well, however, feel free to use another black and white graphic instead. We want to separate the graphic from the white background. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl-click or Command-click the RGB thumbnail to make a selection of it. Open back your Layers panel and click the Lock icon to unlock the layer. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the white background, then deselect it. Drag it onto the tab of the toast document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it. To rotate it, go back to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. Then press Enter or Return. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively, as well as replace it with another graphic or text without having to redo the effects. Change the blend mode to soft light. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. The color is black. The blend mode is color burn, and the opacity is 30%. The technique is softer, and the size is 20 pixels. Then click OK. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 3 pixels. And click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Displace. We'll keep its default settings of 10 stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Find and click your displacement PSD file that you saved earlier, and click Open. Immediately, it made a subtle but important shift, which adds a bit more realism to our image. Open your channels panel. Control-click or Command-click the Alpha 1 channel, which makes a selection of its shape. This is the nooks and crannies of the toast that you saved earlier. Open back your Layers panel. Control-click or Command-click the Layer Mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection next to your graphic. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the effects. But first, if you don't see the small arrow next to the FX icon, widen your Layers panel by going to its left edge and dragging it to the left. Click the arrow to collapse the effects. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the arrow of the copy to open the effects. Double-click Outer Glow to open it in the Layer Style window. Change its blend mode to Linear Burn. Make its opacity 20% and the size 30 pixels. Click Inner Glow. The color is black, the blend mode is Linear Burn, and the opacity is 40%. The technique is softer, the source is edge, the choke is 1%, and the size is 35 pixels. Then click OK. Double-click Gaussian Blur. If you see this message, it's just telling us that the displacement filter will be temporarily turned off while we adjust the blur amount. Blur it 7 pixels and click OK. Next, I'll show you how to replace your graphic with text. Let's collapse the effects. Double-click any smart object to open its source, then hide the layer. Press T to open your type tool and pick a font. I'll pick Cafeta. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. Make its size approximately 100 points. You can adjust it once you type out your text. I'll make its anti-aliasing sharp and center alignment. The color is black. Click on your document and type out your text. If it's more than one line and you'd like to adjust the space between the lines, click this icon to open the character and paragraph panels. Highlight the bottom line and drag the baseline shift icon to the right or left. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. We can close the text panels now. Close the tab of the smart object, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. To adjust its size, angle, and position, shift-click the bottom graphic to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. If you see this message, just click OK. Then, adjust its size, angle, and position. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.